guests, colleagues, and students. It's a true pleasure for me to welcome you all to the 29th International Conference on Microelectronics, hosted and organized by IEEE, under the patronage of the Minister of Education and Higher Education, represented by Dr. Maxim Jaber, who is the Dean of the Faculty of Sciences when I was a student at the Lebanese University. I'm so pleased and honored to see many colleagues coming from more than 23 different countries worldwide gathered here today. Ladies and gentlemen, I will discuss the technical part of this conference in addition to IEEE's community engagement through providing quality education in terms of teaching and learning and promoting scientific research. So, we are gathered here today as a result of outstanding collaboration and contributions of several local and abroad universities, and not to forget the sponsors of this conference, that we are grateful for their support and efforts. As you see here, ICM conference has been held in numerous countries, and it is for the third time in Lebanon, hosted by IEEE. And during the conference, several topics will be discussed, such as the general circuit and design, CAD tools and design, micro and nano electronics, and some emerging specialties. I would like to thank our keynote speakers, Mr. Eric Kerbe from France, and Mr. Michel Rosenfeld from France, and the two tutorial speakers, Mr. Abdel Jawad and Mr. Shibley, and the ambassador representatives, Mrs. Saadi and Mr. Siraj Uddin Habib. The number of total papers submitted to the conference is 154, in which 88 that were accepted will be presented during the 3 days, and all submitted papers are reviewed and evaluated by 3 reviewers per paper. That acceptance rate is 57%, which is considered as a positive mark in such conferences. The submitted papers are from 23 different countries from worldwide, where 539 authors contributed in these research works. As a co-chair of this conference, I present to you the technical part. Let me speak to you as a faculty member at IEEE. As you may know, there are 3 pillars which form the cornerstone of each university. Any university, IEEE, any university worldwide. First of all, teaching and learning. Secondly, scientific research. And thirdly, community service. This conference is organized by IEEE in collaboration with several universities, in addition to other conferences were organized through the year, is within the policy adopted by the IEEE to encourage scientific research and scientists at the same time at the university. So, the research, the scientific research at IEEE, and IEEE consider it as a part of the employment creation and retention. IEEE is keen to its mission by providing student-centered learning experiences through the provision of innovation and responsive academic programs. Not to offer only an academic program. It should be responsive, that meet the needs of the labor market, and not to forget the student's potential. We have to be careful about the student's potential in our classes, at our universities. All of the programs at IEEE are accessible and affordable. And for that reason, we have several branches across Lebanon to equip and to prepare well-rounded graduates, equipped with theoretical and practical skills that create significant economic and social debt. Now we can say that the 3 pillars were translated on the ground at the UN, not only written on paper. What we need now is the government to fulfill its role by at least formulating a national strategy to figure out their priorities at the education and research level, and to help us, all higher education institutions in Lebanon, And then you have to identify, in identifying the employment opportunities in the country and outside the country. Ladies and gentlemen, I look forward to your contribution to make the higher education and the scientific research the very center of our effort. Thank you for lending me your attention. Thanks so much.